Okay, let's take another exercises. So we have dividing decimals, mixed decimals up to 2 decimal places. So we have 82 and 4 tenths divided by 8 tenths. So both the divisor and the dividend has decimal point, meaning they are all decimal numbers. So we will now take into the roll. Okay, first thing that we are going to do, make your divisor a whole number by moving the decimal point to the right. So this is the first step. We move the decimal point to the right one place because there is only one decimal digit. So decimal point now will now be after 8. So 8 becomes a whole number because the decimal point is already outside the whole number. So this becomes a whole number now. Okay, as we move the decimal point one place to the right in our divisor, we will also move the decimal point in our dividend. So we move one decimal point from our divisor. So we will also move one decimal point from our dividend. So that's the rule. If we move one decimal place in our divisor, we will also move one decimal place to our dividend. So the decimal point for our dividend will be after 4. Therefore, it means that our dividend now is a whole number. So it is considered a whole number because the decimal point is already out of the numbers. So our dividend will be 824 and our divisor is already a whole number, which is 8. So that this is now how are we going to write the numbers, because we were able to move the decimal point in our divisor. So divisor becomes a whole number, and in our dividend we move the decimal point one place also, so our dividend is also now a whole number. So we can now start the division. Okay, let's take into the first digit of our dividend. So 8 divided by 8, so we have 1. So 1 times 8, we have 8. So we subtract 8 minus 8, you have 0. So we will bring down 2. Okay, so we have 2. 2 cannot be divided by 8, so we will have 0. 0 then times 8, we have 0. So we will subtract 2 minus 0, we have 2. Then we will bring down 4 because we still have 4 in our dividend. So we will go to the next step. Okay, we will have our next quotient, third digit of our quotient. So we have 24 divided by 8, so we have 3. 3 times 8, we have 24, so we subtract 24 minus 24, we have 0. So we have already done, we have already completed our division. So our answer is 103. So the answer in dividing 82 and 4 tenths divided by 8 tenths is equals to 103. Okay, we will solve another example. We have dividing one digit decimal number by two digit decimal number. So we have 4 and 8 tenths divided by 6 hundredths. Okay, so we will have another example. We have 4 and 8 tenths divided by 6 hundredths. So we have a one digit decimal divided by 2 digit decimals. So how to do the division with a particular number of decimals with this kind? Okay, so we have to again make our divisor a whole number. So how to make our divisor a whole number? we will move the decimal point to the right. Since there are two digits in our divisor, so we will move also two decimal places, going into 0 and going into 6. So we have two decimal places. So we move our decimal point two decimal places to the right. Okay, as we move the decimal point in our divisor two places, we will also move the decimal point in our dividend two places also. But the problem is, in our dividend, we have only one decimal place. So what we are going to do is we are going to add 0. Because we moved two decimal places in our divisor, so we will also move two decimal places in our dividend. Since there are only one decimal place, so we will add 0. And after 0, that's the time we are going to write or place the decimal point. Okay, since our divisor is now a whole number, okay, our dividend is also now a whole number because the decimal point is outside 0, outside the last digit of the number. Therefore, it is considered to be a whole number. So this is now the result of moving the decimal point in our dividend. So we will now start the division. Okay, we will now start dividing. So we have 4 as the first digit in our dividend. So we could not divide 4 by 6 because it is smaller than the divisor. So we will move to the second digit. So this will now become 48. 48 divided by 6. So we will get 8. 8 times 6. So we have 48. So 48 minus 48, we have 0. So we will bring down the last digit of our dividend, which is 0. Okay. Okay, so to complete the digits in our quotient, so we have 0 times 0. 0 times 6, we have 0. So there is no more digits left. So we have completely done the division. So the result of dividing 480 by 6, result is 80. So that the result of dividing 4 and 8 tenths divided by 6 hundredths equals 80. Okay, checking whether our division is correct. So we will do the opposite. We multiply 80 times 6 hundredths. So we have 6 times 0, we have 0. 6 times 8, we have 48. And since there are two decimal places in our multiplier, we will also count two decimal places. So our answer will become 4.80 or 4 and 80 hundredths. But we will disregard 0 because 0 has no value at all. Therefore, our answer now is the same with our dividend. We have 4 and 8 hundredths. Okay, this is all for today's video. To all my subscribers and for those who are new to my channel, thank you for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe my channel so that you will be notified for the next videos that I will be uploading. Once again, thank you and God bless.